In today's quantum mechanics class, we will discuss the bane structure. This is topic 5.32 and it is on page 198. You remember that in the previous lecture, we discussed the free electron gas model. And electrons were free there. They were under no potential, and we can up to some extent approximate that configuration to the conductors, to the metals, in which there is a sea of free electrons and they are observing almost very less potential. They are almost considered as free. But here, now in the bane structure, we will consider materials, the electrons inside the material, and those electrons will be facing potential. The potential here we consider a crystal, then atoms are periodically arranged, and the potential we will be considering here will be a periodic potential. For example, if this is the starting point of the electron, then the electron will experience a potential here, and this is the atom potential. As the potential is only at this point, we will consider the potential in the form of Dirac potential, Dirac delta function. So it is a spike which goes and here. Similarly, when we will go one lattice in this direction, then we will again observe the potential due to the atom to the electron, and it will be another delta potential. For simplicity, we are plotting them in the up direction. Otherwise, the potential is negative here, means the electron is attracted toward the atom. But for the simplicity, we consider the potential just like positive in the up direction. It is making no difference. Here, another lattice and so on. We can go in this direction and we can go in this direction. This is our reference point. This we call is the Dirac comb, because it is like a comb shape, and we call it a Dirac comb. Now, what happens to the electrons when they will pass through these potentials? And in the bane structure, we will discuss this thing. So now we are having a periodic potential, and the definition of periodic potential is that V of X is equal to V of X plus A. Means in this direction, we are having X, and in this direction is V of X. Means on this axis we are having V of X, and on this axis we are having X. So X is going this way, and the potential at this point, mean when we are having only V of X, is the same potential at X plus A or X plus 2A or X plus 3A. So we will discuss this thing, and we will also discuss that what will happen to our wave function. For example, our wave function at the reference point or at the starting point is sine of X. What will happen to this wave function when it will go to another atomic site? So the electron wave function we will discuss, and to discuss this thing, we will discuss the Bloch's theorem for understanding this further. Now, consider that our wave function, let's say consider the atoms, like that arrangement, and we are having, this is our reference atom, and this is at x equal 0. we are giving another atom, 8x plus a, another atom equidistant atom, the nearest constant is a here. So x plus a, another a in it will become x plus 2a, and similarly it will go this way. It will go this way as well because we are having large number of the atoms inside the material. So we will have this as x minus a and another atom here and x minus 2a, and they are going this way as well. So for simplicity, I am not writing x with them because this is the x-axis. So this is point a, 2a, 3 and so on. But if I consider it like this, then I will have to write x plus a and x minus a on this side. Now I know that the wave function here is psi of x, and the wave function here will be psi of x plus a and psi of x plus 2a. Similarly on this side it will be psi x minus a and so on. Now the question is that how we will relate psi of x a with psi of x plus a, whether the wave function will change or not. We are quite sure about one thing, that the probability means whether this will be equal to exactly the same or there will be any constant. We are quite sure about this thing, that psi of x mod square means the probability of the electron at this point is the same as psi of x plus a. Means this is the same. But whether the wave functions will be the same as well, we will have to see this thing. For example, I say that means the electron is equally probable here, the same probability here and here. There is no difference at all because the potential on these points is the same. And we have calculated such thing for the infinite square wave, we have calculated this thing. And for unknown potential, we have also calculated when there was a finite potential. So let's see that what will be this situation. Let's say when I move from here to here, then it becomes c times this, and further I can write that this will be equal to, if I go another point, then psi of x will be c times sine of x plus 2a, and means when this one is sine c times sine x a, when I go to this one, another constant will come in here, and this will be equal to c square sine of x plus a. And when I go another and so on, then I will see that psi of x will be equal to c to the power n, for example. N atoms I have gone there, and psi of x plus a. Now there is something that this, the probability of this wave function and the probability of this wave function should be the same. If I take square of this means the mod square of this and the mod square of this, they should be equal. There should be no difference at all. What does it mean? It means that when these two are, let me write again, when sine of x mod square is equal, then it will be the square of this plus this one, a mod square. What does this mean? It means that this thing is now equal to this thing. So this implies that Cn square is equal to 1. Or I can write that this thing is Cn and 1 square root, or C is the nth square root of 1. And this gives us the idea that we should consider this C such that its mod square is equal to 1. And this is like when I consider sine of x equals c times sine of x plus a, then I am sure about this, that this mod square should be equal to 1 from here. Even its nth root is 1. So c square is equal to 1. And this is possible only, if this c is a complex number. And I write this c is e, I, k, a for example. A is of this latest constant. K is any number. It's a real positive number. And I is the complex diagonal. And now if I take C mod square, then this is E minus IKA, the conjugate of this, into EIKA. And this is equal to E to the power 0. And E to the power 0 is 1. So we are now sure about this thing, that I can write this sign is the sign of x is e to the power I k a and sine of x plus a. Now there is another problem, that in the Bloch's theorem we are having the beauty of periodicity, but we know that the number of atoms in a solid are not infinite. Means the edge will come somewhere, maybe after billions or trillions of atoms, the edge will come. The solid is not an infinite solid, so the edge will come, and this will disturb the periodicity that we consider in the Bloch's theorem. So to cope with this situation, that how we can resolve this issue of periodicity so that periodicity remains maintained. So to do that thing, let's consider that we write sine of x of a, sine of x is equal, or I write sine of x plus a is equal to lambda times sine of x, or I write sine of x plus a is this lambda, I write I k a and sine of x. Now this thing this thing means I wrote here that psi of x is equal to eika, psi of x plus a, and now I am writing psi of x plus a eika psi of x. It's the same thing, because when I write this one, this will go here and it will become e minus ika. E I K A or E minus I K A both are the same thing, because when I write this minus this C, then it will mod square, it will be minus and then it will become plus, means the conjugate will become plus and this will become minus, and again I will be having 1. So it means that this C is true for both plus minus. So if I write it here or here, it is mathematically it's the same thing, and I go atom by atom, means psi x plus a and so on, and finally let's say I reach the atom, the nth atom, which I write n a, means it will become 2a, 3a, 4a, and it will reach n a. So I will write this EIN, capital N K A psi of X. I'm going to the nth atom. Is the number of atoms, some finite number will be there, they are not infinite. But now how to resolve the issue of periodicity? The periodicity issue I will resolve with this. That instead of going this way or this way, if I round this thing in a circle, then what will happen? That, for example, this is the zeroth atom, this is the zeroth atom, then I'm this one, the zeroth atom. And then this will be the first, and then the second, so on, and I move it in the circle and I come back to the circle. So another, and this atom that I reach, this atom will be the next atom here, 8 minus A. This will be X minus A atom, and then this will be again the X equals 0 atom. Now what happens, that this is X equals means when A and this is minus A. Now in between, what I did, that I just want to keep the periodicity going on. So now it's completely periodic. There is no edge effect here. And as I move it, I convert it into a form of a circle, then the plus n here will just lie on this one. Means I go to the atom and then I move it around. Then the nth atom will come here in X minus A. And this will give me the calculation that psi of X is equal to, or if I write psi of X plus NA will be equal to psi of X. See here. I have just placed it here, and when I will just add any atoms, I will get this atom back, means psi of x, starting from the psi of x, and I reach any atoms, as I add up x with this, I will reach back the same atom. And you know that on the same atom, the wave function will be the same. So This was the resolution of the periodicity in the blocks there. Because I consider the electron here on this atom, it is having a wave function. And now I just calculated the wave function on this will also be the same, but if I assume that it is not the same and changes are occurring, but when these atoms are identical atoms, they are the same atom, if I round it like this and it comes here, then the next atom that I will go will be this atom, and this will have the means I will be on the same atom, and that's why this thing will be exactly equal to this, and the problem of periodicity will be solved with this. And of course this thing is equal to E I N K A sine of X as well.